Hey guys, welcome to Game of Point. This is your host, Abong, and welcome to the 15th episode of Weekly Tech News. Now, I know it's been so much time that I posted my last tech news video. I guess it's almost more than 2 weeks since I posted my last tech news video. And the thing was that I was kind of busy in my entire last week. As you guys must have seen in my blog, I was at the Sunburn Pune Festival. Then also, I was not feeling well in the starting of the last week. I was having fever. So, due to which, I couldn't able to make tech news videos. And even you guys, I must have known that the amount of videos in the last week was so much less. I just hardly posted 2 videos in the entire week, so that was the main reason for that. So I just thought to make this tech news a very special cause. I'm gonna cover news from almost last 2 weeks in this only single episode. So I hope you guys will enjoy this episode, cause there will be so much exciting and interesting news that has happened in the entire tech world almost since last 2 weeks. So I hope you guys will enjoy this episode. And of course, before starting the tech news, I wish each and every one of you Happy New Year. I wish all of my subscribers a very happy and prosperous New Year. I hope this year will be very much joyful and pretty much exciting for all of you guys. Cause this year, 2016 was a great, and I must say that a great year for me. I achieved so many new things, and the main biggest thing, that is this YouTube channel. I started this YouTube channel in 2016 only. So 2016 is gonna be a much remarkable year in my entire life. So I hope this 2017 also will bring some new and exciting things. If you talk about my resolution of 2017, then there is one resolution which is related to YouTube, that I want to have at least 10,000 subscribers before 31st of December 2017. So I hope this goal will be possible to achieve, and this is gonna be completely possible with your support only. So if you guys are with me, then definitely I will be able to achieve a lot of new goals and all the new ways on my YouTube journey. So it's all upon your help, and I know that you guys will surely be with me in my entire journey. So thank you for all of you guys in advance only. So now, without waiting any time, let's start with the tech news. So guys, the first news here is coming from Lenovo, that Lenovo Zook Edge is finally official in China. The phone is launched with two variants, the one which comes with 4GB of RAM, another one comes with 6GB of RAM. The cost, accordingly, that 4GB RAM variant will cost ₹22,500 and the 6GB RAM variant will cost ₹24,500. This is the Indian direct conversion. The phone is not yet officially launched in India. If you talk about the specification, then here we'll get a 5.5 inch Full HD display, 13MP back camera, 5MP front facing camera. Snapdragon 821 CPU with 4GB or 6GB RAM combination, then a 3100mAh of battery. So the phone looks great. I would say it's a phone with the edge screen. So this is gonna be a great phone with those edge displays, and this is gonna be one of the most cheapest Snapdragon 821 based smartphone. This is just selling for ₹22,500. If you guys remember, Lenovo Z2 Plus was the cheapest Snapdragon 820 based smartphone, and it's the cheapest Snapdragon 821 based smartphone. So looks great. Let's hope that this will soon come to India. Then the next news here is coming from HTC, that HTC is announcing something that is with the tagline "For You" on January 12. So as you guys can see from this image here, it says "For You" and the date is 12th of January 2017. So there must be something called with the new HTC phone basically, which will come with the tagline "For You." This might be this HTC Desire You or something like that. So it's not yet confirmed what this is actually about, but still, this might look something new phone from HTC with the tagline "For You." So let's see what HTC is going to do with this "For You" concept. This is basically none of our use, cause HTC phones are not that much popular, so there's not that much of craze with the HTC. Then the next news is here coming from Amazon Now. If you guys remember, Amazon Now is the concept in which what you can do basically is, it's a concept, or you can say it's a service in which you can buy grocery products from Amazon with only within 2 hours of delivery time. So let's assume you want to buy something from Amazon that is related to grocery items, so the delivery time will be just within 2 hours. And the service was actually before that available was only in Bangalore, but now it's available in Mumbai and Delhi, only in selective cities basically. So it's a great thing that this kind of service expanding in India. I hope this will be useful for many other people who live in such places, that you can order grocery items and it can be delivered within just 2 hours. So you don't need to wait for 1 or 2 days basically. Then the next news here is coming from Samsung, that Samsung is planning, or again, I don't know if it's confirmed or it's just a rumor, that Samsung is planning to replace the Note lineup with the S8 lineup. So basically what Samsung is planning to do is they are going to replace the Note 8 or whatever the next year's Note will be with the S8 Plus variant. So the Plus variant is the new will be the new version of S8 and which will come with a 6-inch of display. So this is going to be exactly similar with what Note series used to offer. But this is not a confirmed news yet. This is again just a rumor that Samsung might just simply end the Note series and instead of they will continue with the S series only. So let's see what Samsung is planning to do, because if they're gonna ditch the Note lineup, then they need to think about the S Pen, because S Pen is the major highlight of Note series. So if S8 Plus is gonna replace Note or Note 8 or whatever it will be, then the S Pen, I guess the implementation should be there in that phone. Then the next news here is coming from Xiaomi, that Xiaomi has launched a new laptop, or you can say improved, or you can say it's an upgrade over the existing Mi Notebook series that is known as Mi Notebook Air. So this is the Air variant of the Mi Notebook, similar to what Apple offers with the MacBook Air. And there's only one key highlight, that this laptop comes with a 4G support inbuilt. So it's a 4G LTE support based laptop, and it's gonna be work with the China OEM, that is the China Mobile. If you talk about some of the features, then there are two variants, one which comes with 12.5 inch display and another comes with 13.3 inch display. They're getting an OLED display, and overall the design wise, the looks wise, it looks exactly similar. If you talk about the pricing, then the 13.3 inch variant comes with $750, and the one which is a smaller variant which comes with a 12.5 inch display, that comes with a $520. It's not going to come to India, but still this is what it is, that it comes with a 4G support inbuilt. So for those carriers who are running 4G networks in China or other countries, then it's good for them. Then the next news here is coming from again Samsung, that Samsung's Galaxy J7 2017 is been leaked online, as you can see from the images, that the Galaxy J7 2016 is again leaked on the internet. And these are some of the images of the smartphone. If you guys must have noticed, then the design here is completely changed. It's not looking exactly like the previous variant. The ports and everything, the back side looks slightly different. There's a black color plate on the camera side, and also the charging port is also shifted to the left side now. So these are again just the leak images, but overall I feel there's a small change in the design in the Galaxy J7 2017 series. So let's see what Samsung is gonna do. And again, there is a new leak has came that this phone will come with a fingerprint scanner. So at least Samsung is finally shifting and they are moving towards the fingerprint scanner in the mid-range sector. So it's great to see, at least in 2017 they are doing something like this. Let's see what happens with the Galaxy J7 2017. Then the next news here is coming from Apple, that Apple is planning to launch, or you can say again it's in the rumor series, that Apple might launch a new 5-inch iPhone in the next year. As you guys have known, that next year is going to be 10th anniversary of Apple, so that's why Apple is planning to launch something different here. And news, or you can say leaks, are saying that Apple might launch a 5-inch iPhone next year, and that will come with a dual vertical camera. So like iPhone 7 Plus, there will be two, or you can say dual camera setup, but instead of horizontal, it will be vertical. So it's again just a design change, nothing major. But it's just rumors are saying that such kind of thing, or you can say such kind of iPhone is in the works. So let's see what Apple will do for next year. Then the next news here is coming from CyanogenMod. As you guys must have know already, that Cyanogen OS is finally officially end. So that means that's the end of Cyanogen OS. So what actually happened is that Cyanogen OS faced something like issues related to financial issues or something like that. So due to which they just simply shut down their service, all the services related to CyanogenMod. And now the name, or you can say the company, will work under a new name that is known as Lineage OS. So this is what the new name is, and they're gonna do an open source project that will start with some code of CyanogenMod, but in theory get updates and new features over time. So that means there's a new name with some open source project, so the things are gonna be completely different now. You won't be seeing latest, or you can say regular updates such as that you guys have seen with the CyanogenMod. So, and now the Google, if you guys remember, CyanogenMod was supposed to be a killer competitor to the Google's Android, that once they said that they will be simply compete with the Google and very toughly and whatnot. So let's see what CyanogenMod will do. Basically the name is now completely gone, so you're not gonna get latest or regular updates related to CyanogenMod, those phones which are running on CyanogenOS basically. Then the next news here is coming from Xiaomi, that Xiaomi's Mi 6 is in the leaks, that this phone will launch on 6th of February and it will be available to buy in the month of March. So as you guys have known, or I have told you already, that Xiaomi is planning to launch a MWC event. They are planning to set a MWC event in the Barcelona, and in which Xiaomi is planning to launch something new. So the leaks were saying that it will be Xiaomi Mi 6, but now it's saying that Mi 6 will be available It will be basically released on 6th of February only. So let's see what Xiaomi will do with the Mi 6. Again, this will come with the latest flagship CPU, Redmi Snapdragon 6. So Snapdragon 835. So let's see what pricing and what Xiaomi will do with the Mi 6. Then the next news is coming from Motorola, and Motorola's Moto G4, G4 Plus, G4 Play, and all the phones which comes under G4 series are gonna get Nougat update. And basically, they have already started to get the Nougat update at the Android 7.0. So if you guys live in India, news is particularly for the India that the G4 series is gonna get, and which has already started to get the Nougat update on the Moto G4, G4 Plus, and G4 Play variant. So it's good news for all of them, and it was expected that these phones are gonna get Nougat update soon. So it's the time that the Nougat update is started to rolling out. So now go and update your smartphone. Then the next news here is coming from Super Mario Run. That Super Mario Run game is gonna finally available on Android very soon. As you guys must know that this is one of the most popular game currently in the iOS platform, and now the registration for this game is now available on Android. So if you want to play this game on your Android smartphone, then it's soon that this phone is going to be available on Android platform. Basically what you have to do is just simply go to the Play Store and then just search for Super Mario Run and register for the game. Once it's available to download, you will get notification and then you will be able to play this game. Maybe it's for those people who have already registered will be able to play this game early, then it will be available publicly or maybe whatnot. So if you want to play or if you are eager to play this game, then go to Play Store and register for the game, and once it's available, you will be able to play this game. Then the next news here is coming from Nokia, that as you guys we all know that Nokia's Android phones are gonna come next year under the name HMD Global. So HMD Global is the new parent company of Nokia now, and they're gonna launch at least 5 phones by next year. This is what the company is saying. So if you talk about the leaks, there are many leaks about the Nokia smartphone, just like Apple's and Samsung's. So this is one leak has again came, as you guys can see from the images, that there's a sketch and a live phone which is again in the hand of a person. And this is a leak that this is what Nokia is planning to do, or this is basically a sketch art to just give you an idea of what or how will be the look of the new upcoming Nokia Android smartphone. There's again, it's basically similar to what Nokia used to offer with the Asha series, or you can say the Lumia series. But still, let's hope that Nokia will do something good in terms of price and specification. If we talk about the leak specification, then rumors are saying that this will come with a Snapdragon 430, or the lower one comes with the Snapdragon 430, and the mid-range one will come with a Snapdragon 653 or maybe 625 CPU, and all these phones will be running on Android 7.0. So let's see what Nokia will do in the MWC next year. There are so many high hopes about Nokia actually. Then the next news is again coming from Motorola, that Motorola's Moto X 2017 edition is again leaked online, and leaks have started to come about the Moto X. As you guys can see from the images, the look wise the phone exactly looks similar to the earlier generations, or you can say it's almost close to the Moto Z series apart from the glass body. There's a metal body design with the camera bump just like similar to Moto Z or Z Play. Then there's a Motorola dimple on the back, and overall phones looks made up of completely metal. There's a fingerprint scanner at the home button there's in the front. So this is what the leak image is about. So let's see what Motorola will do next year with the Moto X lineup, as we haven't seen the last after almost last year there's any Moto X lineup series in the Motorola X series smartphone. So the X series is not dead, that's what Motorola claims, and now they're planning to launch the X 2017 edition by the next year. Then the next news here is coming from LE Eco, that LE Eco and Coolpad, both the companies came together and they launched a new single smartphone with the collaboration of these two companies, that is known as LE Eco Cool One Dual. So this phone is launched in India both online and offline. So this is kind of a new thing. This phone is available online and offline also. The price of this smartphone is 14,000, that is 13,999. But there's a small catch. There are two variants of this phone, one which comes with a 32GB of internal memory with 3GB of RAM, and another comes with a 32GB same internal memory with 4GB of RAM. But the thing is that the phone which will sold online will be having a 4GB of RAM, and the one which will sold offline will be having a 3GB of RAM at the same cost. So maybe just because of the cost cutting issues or the marketing issue, expenses or whatnot, that's why the company is basically giving 3GB of RAM with the offline variant. But still, the specification overall looks decent. It is having a 5.5-inch Full HD display, then a dual 13MP back camera which can record videos up to 4K, and an 8MP front-facing camera. Apart from that, we are getting a Snapdragon 652 CPU, and the battery here is 4060mAh. So it's a great phone at the cost of rupees 14,000. It's one of the first phone, I guess, which comes with a dual camera setup. So if you are looking for a camera related smartphone which will compete with the Moto G4 Plus, then I think so we can definitely have a look at this phone, which comes with a dual camera setup. So definitely the camera is gonna be great in this smartphone. Then the next news here is coming from again Xiaomi, that there's a new leak claiming that Xiaomi is launching a new smartphone this month only in India. The name is not yet confirmed. Earlier it was like the Xiaomi Micro Redmi Note 4. Then some said that it will be Redmi 4 Prime, as the leak said that the phone will come with a Snapdragon 625 processor. And we all know that Snapdragon 625 is present in the Redmi 4 Prime. But now the new leak is saying that the Xiaomi's new phone will be called a Xiaomi Redmi Note 4X. So this will be the exclusively Snapdragon variant of the Redmi Note 4 basically, which will come with the Snapdragon 653 CPU. So this is going to be the first of the kind phone which will come with the Snapdragon 653 CPU. You guys already know that Redmi Note 4 comes with the MediaTek Helio X20 CPU, which is a deca-core CPU. And since Xiaomi is banned to launch MediaTek CPUs in India, so that's why Xiaomi cannot launch that phone directly. So they are bringing a new improved version, or you can say changed version of the Redmi Note 4 in the name of Redmi Note 4X with the Snapdragon 653 CPU. Other specification will be exactly the same, such as 4GB of RAM, 32 or 64GB of memory combination. So let's see when this phone will come to India, because a lot of people are excited and pretty much waiting for the new Xiaomi phone, which will replace the Redmi Note 3, because Redmi Note 3 is like a killer smartphone of 2017. Then the next news here is coming from Samsung, that Samsung's Galaxy S7 and S7 Edge are gonna get Android 7.1.1 Nougat update by this month only. The beta program of Android 7.1 of the S7 and S7 Edge is finally end now, and the official rollout of this update will be started to happen almost within 1 or 2 weeks. So the news is saying that both these smartphones will get the Android Nougat update by this in the coming 2 weeks. So it's good news for those users who are using Samsung's latest but the only surviving flagship smartphone. So you're gonna get Android Nougat update pretty much soon. Then the next one is coming from Samsung as well as Apple, that Samsung will be the only exclusive provider to the supplier of AMOLED panels for one of the Apple's iPhone that will be launched in this year. So Apple is planning to use the Samsung's displays, or you can say Samsung's AMOLED panels, for this year's iPhone. So this is what the news is saying, and you guys, it's like completely different, because generally we have seen a lot of clashes and a lot of lawsuits between Samsung and Apple, but now Samsung is and Apple is coming together to just simply supply the display panels to the Apple, and in which they will do something together, or basically this is what it is. Then the next issue is coming from Google Play, that Google has planned to use the Airtel and Vodafone billing method in the payment option of Google Play Store. So that means till today we used to always only pay anything which we want to purchase, whether it's in-app purchase or direct app purchase, from the Play Store via credit card only. There was no option of debit card or whatever. So now the new two options has been added for India exclusively, that you can pay the same amount, or you can make the purchases in the Google Play Store from your Airtel or Vodafone postpaid bills. So it's not for prepaid, it's only for postpaid users, that you can now pay the amount, or you can say make the payments from your Vodafone or Airtel postpaid bill only, and the amount will be added in your phone's bill. So it's a good news that they have added a new option such like this, because if your person don't have credit card, then they can't simply make the payment. But now in such cases, you have option of postpaid payment from Airtel and Vodafone. And finally, the last news is coming, and it's one of the trending news right now in India at least, that there's a new application which is launched by our Indian government that is called as BHIM application. So the name is funny, somewhere trolling that it's Chota BHIM or Mota BHIM or whatever. But the BHIM application is the new application which is a UPI based payment method, and in which, or you can say due to which, you can now simply transfer your money to another person using this application to directly the bank account. And this is excellent way, I would say it's a great way, because before this application we used to use whether Paytm or FreeCharge, or whether the native mobile applications from the various banks, and in such cases not all the banks have great amount of great applications in the Play Store, or you can say App Store. Only selective banks such as HDFC, ICICI have decent applications, but some low rate banks don't have their mobile apps. So in such cases the online fund transfer was a major issue. But now with the help of this BHIM application, you can now simply transfer the money from another person's bank account to another person's bank account from your mobile phone only. So it's implemented in your phone's mobile number. So with the help of your mobile number only, you can transfer the money from various bank accounts to another bank account. And it's a great way actually. The full form of this application is Bharat Interface for Money, And it's a great way to just simply transfer money instantly to another bank account. You can add your bank details. Basically, you don't need to add. You just need to simply select your bank and enter your mobile number, which is connected, or you can say register to your bank account. And now then the app can simply automatically identify your bank account and other details. And then you can start transferring money in case you don't have cash. The only thing is that the number of banks is, the list of banks is limited. The sad thing is that my personal bank account, in which my account, in which bank my account is not available in this application, and due to which I cannot transfer money. And you can say basically I cannot use this application because my bank is not available in the list of this selective bank names. So this is a sadness for me at least, but still pretty much the well-known, or you can say famous, banks of India are in the list of this available banks. So you can now just simply use this application. It's a great way, so you don't need to download Paytm or other wallets, third-party wallets basically. So that's all for this week's episode of Weekly Tech News. I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. I tried to cover as many as possible important as well as exciting news from almost last 2 weeks, so this video might be so much lengthy, I guess, but still I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. If you do enjoy this, then I really appreciate if you can click the like button below. Also, if you haven't subscribed to Gamer Point, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below, and even here when the GP logo will appear, or maybe here, wherever it will appear, just simply don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed already, to see some awesome technology related videos, some more tech product unboxing reviews, and some awesome tech news videos which I post every Sunday. So that's all for this video, and thank you guys so much for watching. I wish again each and every one of you Happy New Year. So I'll see you in my next video. Until then, bye bye and take care.